Good morning, folks. Frank Zarella here. Thursday, the 29th of March, doing a quick video in regards to the market. As you already know, the market has been under some pressure lately. This month so far, the drawdown from this high it's about roughly 8%. We're seeing a little bounce today. But very simply, the market goes up and down, not up or down. So even in bear corrective markets, you're going to get bounces. And if you've been strict with your stop loss discipline, if you've been disciplined with your stop losses, chances are that you've been stopped out of a lot of stocks, and you probably have a decent amount of cash on hand. So with that being said, you know, the SPY here is down, you know, 11 out of 13 days retesting this 200-day moving average. The Qs pretty much look the same, but what's interesting to me here is that yesterday they finally caught up to the general, and the last man standing, Amazon, took a beating. And normally, you know, in corrective markets, when you have a correction, they normally wait until the very end to take apart the big leaders, and that's what they did yesterday with Amazon and also Netflix a little bit. So the minute I saw Amazon down 100 points, I thought that finally they caught up to the general, and I immediately put on the trade on TNA at $66 a share with a stop at 63. Because again, normally, the you know, once you get the last man that's been standing for a while, that typically, for the most part, based on what I've seen, it typically leads to a bounce, a short-term bounce, not the end of a correction, but a short-term bounce. And remember, the market goes up and down, not up or down. With that being said, there are a few stocks that I have an interest today on the long side, if and only if they're able to get through yesterday's highs. LGND, you know, the stock has been in a very nice uptrend. Back here to the 50-day moving average, I like the stock going through 163.48. The stop, I don't think you have to wait until it gets to 158 to stop yourself out. I think this stock, again, breaks below the 50-day moving average. Call it, you put a stop at 159. It's probably a good place to put your stop. But I like the stock going through 163.48, if and only if it gets through that level. SPAR has been holding up extremely well, Spartan Motors. I like the stock going through 1735, stop loss right over here at 1660, 1650. CMG has been trading sideways for roughly about 7 months. You know, every time it gets to this stop, to this resistance level here, it pulls back. But here recently, it's been holding up very well. It's been tightening up right underneath this lateral resistance. I like the stock going through 323.92, stop at 316. Labo, which is XBI, triple biotech ETF, is the one that I'm most excited about. A nice little wick pattern here, big hammer. I like the stock, this ETF, going through 79.50. Again, you can put a stop more than likely at $76 a share. I don't think you have to wait all the way over here. And what we're looking for is this type of action right over here. We got a big wick, big hammer here when the market was somewhat oversold, and then we got a decent bounce. So I'm looking for the same thing here. I'm looking to get involved if and only if it gets through 79.50. Hopefully they don't gap it up too early in the morning. FN, you know, here's a stock that had a big move based on earnings back on 2.6. Big move, digested the move very well, then took off, was holding up extremely well, you know, even through the market weakness, and they finally got to it over the last few days. I like the stock going through 31.21, so more than likely I'll have a buy stop at 31.31 and a stop loss right over here at 29.90. So trading well and be well. And remember, the market goes up and down, not up or down. I don't think even in the worst corrective markets, you can go back 2002, 2008, even in those horrible, horrible bear markets, we always had bounces. And the bounces during bear markets are brutal. So just being short because you think the market is going a lot lower, it's not as easy as you may think, because the bounces in bear markets, corrective markets, are large, extremely large. So trade them well and be well.